How's it going, guys? It's ZDEyee here. So I wanted to share my first impressions on Dragon's Dogma 2. And before I proceed, I wanted to mention, guys, I do apologize regarding my voice. I'm a little bit sick, I got a stuffy nose, and I actually been sick for the past few days as well, unfortunately. So I'm trying to recuperate. Now back in track regarding of my first impressions on Dragon's Dogma 2. Well, it's an interesting game, I want to say. Like, I have quite a few thoughts that I definitely want to share. I got some of the pros and cons, of course, but yet also I want to first of all mention that I did not play the first Dragon's Dogma game, right? I believe it came out in 2012, I believe, like, and basically it completely went under the radar for me, right? I never even heard of it until, like, we got a final proper announcement of Dragon's Dogma 2 for the first time, and a lot of people, few people I should say, like, actually gave me recommendations and asked me to give it a shot, play it, try it out, see what you think about it. Now, I never did because, again, it did feel like that it would not have been my sort of a game or my cup of tea, if that makes sense. But nevertheless, I just simply ignored it, unfortunately. Now, with the Dragon's Dogma 2, with its release, I initially was not going to pick it up. But I actually got an access code for it unexpectedly, and this was actually an awesome opportunity for me to give it a shot finally and play it for myself, and you know what, share my proper thoughts on the game. And I'm kind of torn regarding that. I'm not sure if I'm liking it or I'm just simply, you know, just going through this world for the sake of it, just for, you know, for just my review, my initial thoughts, and that's it. And that's not a good sign, at least at the moment. So I want to get into the positives and of course the negatives. For example, I do like the world, right? Like, you get to explore, you get to see a few new awesome things within this world. But then there's also a negative on that front as well. Like, for example, what is it that you genuinely in core that you do within this game, right? And anyway, going from point A, from point to point B, right? And so basically all you most of the time do is, well, combat. You encounter the enemies, you encounter goblins, encounter orcs, encounter cyclops, and encounter many different varieties of creatures, and genuinely a lot of variations in terms of what I have noticed already from playing around, give it take 9 to 10 hours of the game. And like I said, this is not my full reviews, my first impressions, and I could be wrong regarding of that's give how many different varieties of enemies there are. And so I've been playing through and just, you know, having an okay time. But then I started to notice more and more and more that, wait, is that it? You know, kind of like question in my mind, I started questioning it. But okay, that's fine, that's no big deal. Now, then they kind of introduced the mechanic of a pawn system. I really, really like pawn system, mate. Like, seriously, it's so much fun. Like, I love the way you have a variety of choosing your own NPC friendlies that you can have going up to this incredible adventure with your buddies, basically. Right, if you want, you can have an archer as an example, while you playing, for example, a thief. And I'm, by the way, playing mainly as a thief. I'm thinking about changing it to a sword wielder, like with a heavy knight or some sort. I don't know yet, because I feel like a thief is a little bit, maybe it's just me because I'm not yet too proficient with the game and I'm not too sure how everything plays out yet. It just feels like thieves a little bit underpowered to me. But anyway, that's just my thoughts. And again, things will definitely change by the time I perhaps will finish this game. So of course, you know, I got an archer by my side. I got a mage by myself to make sure that she covers my back, basically keeps me healed up as well. I like the way you can have your own main pawn as well, so you actually have an opportunity of creating this character. I decided to make a female, elf. Even though I noticed that there's no elves in this race, other than beastmen, of course humans. I was kind of disappointed about that. To be honest with you, I have heard a little bit about that Dragon's Dogma 2, you also have varieties of languages. And for example, at first you would have difficulties encountering with elves, and so you can't speak their language. And I thought about, wait, well, can't I just like hire an elf or make my own elf, and so they can actually speak in their own elf language? But then it's like, oh man, there's no elf race that you can choose. And I was like, oh, come on. And personally, I really want to play as, like, you know, and have my companion being an elf. I think it was kind of cool, unique in that front. But unfortunately, you can't really do that. At least not to an extent. Now, I do know there's some ways of doing it so you can actually learn the language, or at least your pawn can learn the language too. So I'm curious to see how that will work out, but I'm not yet too sure how to do that at the moment. Maybe I'm looking into it way too far in. But anyway. So I like the way there's so many big battles and moments that Eugenio can actually encounter. Like, right, I have already mentioned, for example, there's a griffin fight that you can encounter. At one point, I was facing off the specific griffin, right? I simply started climbing on this, well, on a griffin, and I stayed on his back. He brought me to his nest, and I started attacking him. Somehow, pawns actually found their way to me, thankfully, and yet I was facing off this griffin. I had a very difficult, challenging battle, and then another griffin, I don't know where it came, and this guy was even bigger than the one I was facing, and unfortunately I couldn't even kill any of them because I feel like I was maybe underpowered, and I constantly kept on using my resources, you know, my health kept going down, and I just, like, by the time I was like, man, I'm about to die here, and my health was like completely drained, so unfortunately I had to restart from the last checkpoint. Now here's the problem, here's the big, big fucking con, and I'm gonna say it, I don't give a shit. I hate the way this is only one save point. I don't like it, it's stupid. I don't agree with this decision. Like, I'm glad the way that you actually can still, like, say maybe you die and you go to the last checkpoint, I'm glad the way there's that. But then what if you mess up or something? Or what if there's a glitch or something? Then your checkpoint isn't gonna help you, and if it just doesn't, then you're fucked, basically. And then you thankfully you still have an option of actually going back to the inn, but you lose so much progress, that's incredible. Like, for example, you could be in the end game at the moment, but last time you were at the inn, it was like the beginning of the game. You lose like 20-30 percent of your progress. Well, not percent, like 20-30 hours of your progress. No thanks. That's a dumb system, and I don't agree with it. Oh my god, don't get me started on the performance of the Dragon's Dogma 2. Seriously, I'm playing this game on my PlayStation 5, and I'm constantly getting interrupted with these stupid frame rate issues. Like, I'm not sure if this game is running on 20 FPS, 30, maybe 40, if I'm, you know, if you're lucky, of course. But I've been playing this game for, you know, for a little bit, and I'm constantly interrupted to the point I'm just like, maybe I should just wait, you know what I mean? Let's just wait until the next patch comes out or the following patches after that. And so it freaking fixes this damn game, because it really started getting me nauseous. Like, basically, I'm playing the game and I'm like, oh my god, I can't handle this. It feels sick, you know, like, not like in terms of sick of being like I feel bad about this game. It's just I feel sick about it because I'm constantly looking at it and there's so many interruptions and frame rate issues. I'm just like, I cannot believe that they decided to release this game so badly unpolished. And that's a very, very big minus. Another con. This game is extremely unfriendly to newbies. I'm serious. Like, this game, the amount of things that I'm noticing within this game that a lot of people even kind of warned me about, not warned me, just in general, gave to newbies a warning, such as myself, that this game doesn't have a fast traveling system other than you can use an ox heart. Oxford, whatever the hell it's called, basically a system that you can actually fast travel in itself, and of course there's some repercussions in that as well. For example, there could be occasions, so if you doze off, there could be some enemies that you'll still have to fight off, but you don't reach your destination that you initially would expect to go, and it actually happens quite occasionally. And I'm also kind of not liking, due to if you make your way on foot, is it me, but the amount of enemies in this world is just ridiculous amounts. I feel like there's too much going on. They need to cool down with the enemies that are within the open world. Like, constantly, every time I go through on the main road, and I'm just like, okay, well, goddamn, there's goblins there. Oh my god, there's some bandits there. Oh my god, there's an ogre there. Oh my god, there's a cyclone there. And I'm just like, I'm still going my merry way. I didn't reach my destination. And I'm just like, I'm getting pissed off about this, you know, because due to this, I'm losing stamina. I'm losing my health. And I cannot replenish my health because your health diminishes. Unless, of course, if you go to sleep, then you can get all your health back up, as I understood how you play through the game. But of course, if you don't find campsites, and your campsites can get attacked as well while you're dozing off or sleeping, it's really, really unfriendly to you. It doesn't actually respect your time. And that's a very big minus for me, I'm sorry. Like, I know that Dragon's Dogma, as in its core name, that people would tell me, for example, you shouldn't really be expecting these things to happen already, were like in the or the other games, right? Like modern games, of course, they have these save points. You're able to kind of do save scumming as well. I understand all that. But then there's also some games just let you to fast travel everywhere. In this game, you really can't. I know you there's a fairy stone system or something, whatever it's called. I've used it once because like I was like at the north of the part of the map and I was, do I really want to go back all the way to the town? Fuck this, I'm gonna use my fairy stone. And I'm just like, I got four left and I'm just like thinking, man, it's so hard to get these things. And I'm just like, should I be using it? But then I was thinking to myself, if I end up going back with the minuscule health that I've got left, and just like, I'm gonna be so annoying to the point I'm just gonna abandon this game. Because there were some instances that three times I almost abandoned this game three darn times, and I'm just worried. That's why I said in my beginning of the commentary that I'm a little bit torn about this game, that I feel that if there could be too many of these occasions that could happen, for example, that okay, this is bullshit and I don't want to go through with this, and if this keeps on happening, I will end up abandoning this game because it seems like it's just not good enough for me. But at least that's what I feel like, right? And again, that's, I don't know, it's very just unfriendly to new players, at least to me, and it just doesn't respect your time as well. And I'm just like, I've had with it, because like after Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, how much it really doesn't respect your time of hundreds of hours of playtime you will actually need, and that's what I'm talking about, even main quest, of course. It's just ridiculous. And I'm just looking at Dragon's Dogma 2 and I'm like, oh my god, I've had enough of this. You know, that kind of feeling you can get, it can get really, really, it can burn you out, basically. Well, I do think that the graphics are on the con side. I do think that the graphics are not exactly particularly beautiful, what the world has to offer and how beautiful it looks. Now, there are occasions it genuinely looks stunning. It looks beautiful, gorgeous, the color and schemes and stuff like that. The horizon, the vistas, it genuinely is beautiful on that front. But there are occasions such as grayed out, dull, boring, just not very interesting or not very appealing moments as well. And to the point, it's just not like it's not like the developers chose to make this game not appealing or dull because the moments within the atmosphere, right? No. It just genuinely doesn't look good. I don't know. That's why I say that's more of a mix between the two, from a pro, from a con. Personally, for me, so far, the game isn't exactly a looker. So that's why I put it in more of a con category. I want to say that the tracking quests that you have to do within this game is very annoying. I do not like it. For example, if you want to get to from point A to B, you have to initiate this specific quest, right? So, okay, you find them occasionally. There's a main quest. There's also moments for a side quest. There's some time limit ones as well. It's okay, that's a cool and interesting kind of development. And of course, we've seen plenty of times in different RPG games as well. But then when I look at how this game implements it and how much it really doesn't, how can I say, respect your time. So I go to this quest, I make my way there, I defeat the specific enemy, then I have to like think about, okay, how am I gonna get back? Now, I do get my reasoning why I don't like some parts about this game. Because I did some digging, and perhaps it's just me, because I was like thinking, wait, am I just torn about this game? Do I like it? Do I not like it? And then I think I figured out my issue with this game. I'm so used to modern titles of open world games. Fast traveling, it's respecting your time, and also there's just no issues with that, right? It makes sense. There's a waypoint system going from way A to going to the point B. Just brainless, right? You don't have to think about it. It's not a good design, it really isn't. It's overused, Ubisoft does it, and a lot of other games does it. It's not just Ubisoft that the only ones at fault in here. But in this case, I'm just got so used to that, maybe, perhaps. And maybe that's why I'm so torn about this game. And yet, also, what I'm trying to find within Dragon's Dogma 2 is a reason to see my progress, right? I want to feel getting stronger. At the moment, I don't. Because perhaps, like I mentioned already, maybe Thief class isn't for me, and that's why I want to feel stronger, and that's why I want to make a choice of going with the Sword class. I don't know. It's such a weird feeling. So, at the moment of my progress and how much I've been playing this game, I'm just feeling torn. And of course I will make an updated video and perhaps even my full review as well, and I'll let you know how I went with in terms of finishing the game. Have I finished it? Have I abandoned it? You know, you will know everything basically by that time. I do not know when I'll be finished with it, but I do hope that I will get it done before Final Fantasy 16 DLC will be released. Either way, thank you so much for watching, guys. Like and subscribe. I'll see you guys all and have a wonderful day.